We can discuss some problems. So in this question, a charge distribution with spherical symmetry has density rho v is equal to rho naught r by capital R for a radius from 0 to capital R and 0 elsewhere, and you are asked to find the electric field. Okay, so you can just assume a sphere and let this be having a radius, say capital R. This is the center. So here you can take it only as two cases. You have to take it as case 1 and case 2. Why? Because the charge distribution is not uniform throughout. Till the radius r, what is the charge density? It is rho naught r by capital R. This is valid only inside this sphere. Outside, the charge density is 0. So in this case, what will happen? Here only there is charge and outside there is no charge. So when you are asked to calculate electric field, what do you have to do? You have to calculate it separately. So if you are asked to calculate D or E, D is, what is D? D is electric flux density. Okay, that is epsilon E. This is the equation connecting D and E. D is electric flux density and E is electric field density. So even if you are asked to calculate D or E, the method is same. Just the difference is, if you are first calculating E, you just have to multiply it with the constant value epsilon to get vector D. So for both calculating, say, D or E, the method is the same. So what do you have to do? When charge distribution is given like this, you have to take it as two separate cases. So you are assuming an area, taking into consideration this sphere, and when you have to calculate the electric field at a point P. So this, that point P can be inside the sphere or outside the sphere. Okay, so, and what is small letter r? This is small letter r, r. Okay, small letter r means it is the coordinate of the particular point P that we are considering. So case 1, how you can define? Case 1 is when the point is within the charge density. That means R less than or equal to R. That is one case. And case 2, when the point is outside the sphere. Okay, within the sphere means it is within the charge density. Second case, which is greater than R here. Here you can say that here it has a coordinate R that will be greater than capital R. So you take it as two cases. One, when it is inside the sphere with charge density, and the second case when the point is outside the sphere, which is containing the charge. Okay, and the last step only, you need to substitute the charge density here. Rho v is equal to rho naught r by capital R. Okay, till that you can just assume that there is some charge, say rho v, within capital R. So you should know the difference between small r and capital R. Small r is the coordinate of the particular point, but capital R is a constant. It is given in question. Only till r, capital R, there is a charge density given by rho naught small r by capital R. Okay, so here capital R is a constant. Whenever you integrate or differentiate, you should learn, understand that also. Capital R is a constant, but small r, it is a variable. So when you differentiate or integrate, you have to consider the variable small letter r. Okay, that is the corresponding coordinate in the spherical coordinate system with the three coordinates r, theta and phi. So this r is the variable here. Okay, whereas capital R is a constant value. So here I have given the answers. So the first step is you have to apply Gauss law. Okay, you know what is Gauss law? What is Gauss law? That gives this equation, psi is equal to Q enclosed. The total electric flux is equal to the charge enclosed. So left side you can write psi, electric flux. Electric flux definitely for any quantity, the density of that quantity into area will give you the total quantity. So psi can always be written as, what is flux density? Flux density is D. D into area, that is multiplying by area. That is what we are doing with surface integral. So surface integral of D dot ds, that is equal to psi, which is the total electric flux, that is equal to Q enclosed. Here it is given the charge density. So again, rho v into volume, that is equivalent to rho v into volume is equal to taking the volume charge density, rho v dv. So again, you can write it as volume integral of rho v dv. So you know this. This is the common equation which we apply for Gauss law. Psi is equal to q, psi is equal to surface integral of d rho ds, and q is equal to volume integral of rho v dv. So this is the equation. Now you are considering the two cases r less than or equal to r. Why we take it as two cases, I explained earlier. So when r less than or equal to r, what is the meaning of this? This is inside the sphere. Okay, it is inside the sphere with the charge. Okay, that's why we first take it as r less than or equal to r. Again, you are applying this. What you know is it is a sphere. So area, there is no need to integrate. Even if you integrate, you will get the same answer. So in sphere, we already know. So we need not waste time on that. So area, that is 4 pi r square. Because here what you are taking is a particular point. So you can never take this r as capital R. Why? Because the point can vary at each time. We are integrating. So 4 pi r square here, value is small r, which is the coordinate, into it is d. So d is epsilon naught e, and when it is spherical, we assume the electric field to be radially pointing outward. So that's why it is only having radial component. That's why we write it as er. So epsilon naught er, that means this is the value of d and it is radial, so you can write even as dr. So here our assumption was dr is equal to epsilon naught er. So epsilon naught r we are taken here. So instead of d, you took dr, which is epsilon naught er, and ds, surface in, instead of surface integral, as sphere has area 4 pi r square, we directly substituted that, is equal to rho v dv. So rho v dv, you know that rho v is equal to rho naught r by capital R. Here in question it is given rho naught r by capital R. Okay, so you are substituting that. You can see it clearly here. That is rho, volume integral of rho v dv means rho naught r by capital R into dv. Okay, when you integrate dv, you know that in spherical coordinate system, dv is equal to r square sine theta dr d theta d phi. Okay, in addition to this, this r is here in our value itself. So you can take the constant outside and you can write rho naught by r into volume integral of this r into r square. That is r cube into sine theta into dr d theta d phi. Okay, so dv is this value. In any spherical coordinate system, we know this. This we already covered in first module. R square sine theta dr d theta d phi into, here there is an r. So that also you need to multiply when you take the volume integral of charge density. So you got it as r cube. Now you are separately integrating. R cube dr, you are integrating integral r cube dr. Then you are integrating sine theta d theta. Again you are integrating d phi. Always the limit for phi will be 0 to 2 pi. Okay. And pi will be varying from 0 to pi. When you take the whole sphere, the limit of theta will be from 0 to pi and phi will be from 0 to 2 pi. If you want to know why we get these two limits, you will have to check the coordinate system diagram in first module. That will show clearly that the limit is only till pi in case of theta. And in case of phi, it can take all the 360 degrees. So it is 0 to 2 pi. Now you are substituting the limits. R cube on integrating r raised to 4 by 4. Again, sine theta on integrating, it is minus cos theta. D phi on integrating, it is phi. Applying the limits, you will be getting the answer. So here you get the answer. Left side, already you have an answer and you are equating both sides and you will be getting the value of ER. This is the scalar value only. Okay, you are asked to calculate electric field, which is a vector. So what you have to do, in addition to the scalar quantity, you are giving the unit vector AR. As we know that when it is a spherical charge, the electric field will be radiating outwards, radially outwards. So that's why we assume that the electric field has only one direction, and that is along the radius which is given by AR. So this is the magnitude part and this is the unit vector to represent that it is pointing radially outwards. So this is the first case, that is when the point was inside the charge density. Now the second case is when the, if we assume a point outside the radius, so that is the second case. When r greater than r means you are assuming a sphere with radius capital R and the charge inside the sphere was rho v is rho naught r by capital R. Now you are taking a point P which is outside the radius R. Here R is greater than R. Here electric field is, or the charge is zero. But that doesn't mean that at point P there is absolutely no charge. There is a charge, there is an electric field due to this charge distribution. So you have to take it separately. So till R, what you are going to do is always in the left part, whether R is less than R or when R is greater than capital R, whatever it is in left side, the area is just 4 pi R square. Okay, so there is no difference for the left side. How you are doing? Psi is equal to Q. Psi is again D, surface integral D dot ds, that is D into area, that is 4 pi R square. So there is no difference in this part. Okay, D into 4 pi R square. Again, you are writing epsilon naught ER into 4 pi R square. This is same as in last case, but in right side there is change. How you change it? After you put the limits, same as last case, theta is varying from 0 to pi, phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi. But what about the limit for R? Earlier you take the limit of this R, dr part, you took it from 0 to capital R. Why? Because till capital R, charge density is remaining constant. But in this case, R is greater than R. So you cannot integrate in a single step. Why? Because when R is greater than R, the charge density is varying. Till 0, from 0 to R, it is rho v, which is given by rho naught R by capital R. But when R is greater than R, it is 0. So you have to integrate it in two steps. So integral 0 to R. In earlier case, it was like this, but here you have to write 0 to capital R, 0 to capital R when there is a charge density rho v, and plus capital R to small r when the charge density is 0. That's why you split the two integrals. But after R, there is no charge density, so it will be 0, so this part will get cancelled. So only you have to take the first part. Okay, again, as I explained in the last step, what is dv? It will be R square sine theta dr d theta d phi. Okay, again, here you know that rho v is equal to rho naught R by capital R. So same integration method. The only difference is in the earlier case it was 0 to small r, but now it is 0 to capital R. You are integrating the whole thing. You are getting the right side part and equating. You are getting ER. This is only the magnitude, and to get the vector, you add the unit vector. Okay, so I have clearly mentioned the difference where it is coming and the complete step is shown. You have to try this problem by yourself and check if you are getting the correct answer.